Welcome guys to day 4 of the 7-day Shopify challenge. So those of you who are brand new to the channel or have no idea what's going on, over the next 7 days I'll be taking a brand new Shopify store live from 0 to 1k in sales. So on the first day we went ahead and set up a website and we also installed the essential apps required for dropshipping. And then day 2 we found a winning product that we were potentially going to test. Day 3 we went ahead and looked at Instagram influencers, how we can contact them and how we could find winning pages. And day 4, which is today, we're going to be going over how to negotiate effectively with influencers as well as make the most amount of money as possible from our Instagram page from our product test. So again guys, over the next 7 days I'll be revealing to you a specific aspect about dropshipping, telling you guys how you can master that specific aspect and make the most amount of money as possible. So at the end of the 7-day challenge, I'll be giving away this 1k in sales Shopify store to one lucky subscriber. So if you want to be a lucky subscriber to win the Shopify store, all you need to really do is be super engaged in the comment section down below, comment 1k again, subscribe to my channel, like all my videos, notification bell icon so that you're notified every time I drop another awesome video. And basically, the more I see your name pop up, the more likely you are to win the store. And I've seen some people super engaged. You really need to be trying hard to engage as much. Even on my Instagram at alexphilip_1, go like all my posts and you're way more likely to win the store. But with that being said guys, we're going to jump into my screen real quick and show you guys how you can negotiate with influencers, as well as a quick update on what I've been doing in the meantime. And then we're going to go into my phone and hopefully it records this time, because last time I spent like an hour recording and it didn't record. But yeah, we're going to jump in my phone and then go ahead and negotiate with influencers and then set up our first influencer deal. So that being said guys, I hope you do enjoy and let's jump into it. Okay guys, so we're going to go ahead and start negotiating with Instagram influencers. So first thing first is we want to change this rubbish logo that we have. So I went ahead and set myself a proper logo. And again, we haven't spent money on it. We just took a free one and from the website, and then we just click done. And maybe just zoom in a little bit so it looks a bit better. And then also what we want to do is quickly post on our feed. And yesterday I was talking to you guys about maximizing conversions. Another main aspect about that is the things that you have posted on your feed. So I've kind of rearranged the way I recorded this video. So the part where I found all the content I'm going to post on my feed and the part where I created the caption is at the end of the video, and this is at the beginning, so skip to the end of the video if you want to know how I found all this content. But basically here is the captions I'm going to be using. So I went ahead and found some captions on winning stores that were successfully dropshipping this item, and then I kind of took them and edited them to make them fit our theme. So one thing I noticed was that most of them were selling the benefits, you know, they were asking a question first of all, like, don't you wish you had white teeth? And what that does is it immediately grabs people, tells people, they ask themselves that question, don't I wish I had white teeth? And this is like a rhetorical question. Everyone would, by default, say yes, they want white teeth to this question. And that's when you immediately come in and you start selling your product. So this store was doing quite well. So I'm going to kind of blend together all of these captions. And I know I saw another store that was selling quite well, and the main benefit it was listing was a new natural way of teeth whitening. So let's go ahead and just copy this. So let's copy the first one that we got, and we're just going to add parts of the other captions into it. So here's the content that I found, and I found a mix of posts and videos because that tends to do the best. And then we're going to go ahead and post one post, one picture, and then one video, and keep on alternating like that. So let's go with the lifestyle image first. That's a nice way to self our feed. Let's go paste. Slim edition teeth whitening pen is amazing. So we're going to test different captions to see which one is selling best. So grab it for a mega 50% off, link in our bio. We're just going to leave this one as that for time being, and let's see how that one performs. And if you want to know how good a caption has performed, all you need to do is click here. And then if you're a business account, so I haven't set up Instagram business account yet, so I'll probably do that soon. But if you're a business account, when you click over here, there's something that says view insights. And when you view insights, you can see how many people clicked on this post and then went onto the website. So the more people that are clicking on a post and then going onto the website shows that ad copy is more effective. So let's say if 100 people saw it and then 10 people clicked on it to go to the website, then that's quite good. If 100 people saw a different caption and only one click to go to the website, then that caption is probably bad. So yeah, we're going to leave that one as that, and let's go post. And let's make sure that the caption is tagging right. One time I typed in my store name and it wasn't actually working properly, and that just resulted in the loss of sales, so that's fine.
and that's fine. You always want to make sure you're double checking everything you're doing is okay. Let's go that. We're going to jump into negotiating real soon, but we want to go ahead and set up our feed first. And then we want to post a product image like this. We'll go ahead and post that. And this time we'll use the other caption and see how good that one is performing. Don't you wish you had white teeth? There. Let's copy this here. And see if that's working fine as well. Sure, that one's working. That one's working. Yeah, I've seen people link or tag themselves incorrectly and they just basically missed out on a ton of sales, because if they had actually linked, tagged themselves on the post correctly, then they would have got more sales, at least a few sales. Let's go post one more live sale image. And then we're going to post a product image relating to the product, a video relating to the product, sorry. So we'll probably go ahead and use this one because this is the least best one I found. I want to click next. And let's go ahead and blend the captions together, actually. So don't you wish you had whiter teeth? So let's use this bit. Don't you wish you had whiter teeth? And then let's post it. Okay, I'll copy that there. And then we'll say new way of whitening your teeth. New natural way of whitening your teeth. So you want to think of the benefits of the product. Natural is like what people like. People don't like putting chemicals in their mouth. So natural is always good. So we'll do natural. And then we say link in bio, and then we do tax on leaders, and that pretty much wraps up that caption. And that's a pretty solid one. We're going to go ahead and test if that's working fine again. We're going to like all our posts. Again, we didn't buy followers or anything, so we want to make sure that the actual feed post aspect of our page is good, just to justify the fact that we don't have followers. Okay, so let's do this one now. How to use. I'll go ahead and use that same caption. And then let's do another lifestyle image. We'll use that one. We'll use this caption there. And then we quickly post the last two images as well. So this is a fairly organized feed. We don't want too many videos next to each other. We don't want too many posts next to each other. And this one was a good video, so we'll change the cover image. And I believe that was all the content that we did have available to us. So let's just check if that's posted properly. There was one more video that I'm waiting to post. And let's go ahead and post the last one real quick. And post. And our feed should look pretty clean once this is posted. Okay, so let's scroll up. And let's say someone's just come to our profile, so home of teeth whitening. We scroll down their feed. The feed looks pretty good. I'm pretty impressed with that feed. Lifestyle images like this. And then we have the videos as well, which helps sell the item, which is good. And then we have one more that's loading. So we want to keep it organized like this. It will fill up the whole three rows because there's two more videos that are loading. But let's go into negotiating with influencers right now. So we'll go ahead and click our DMs and we see 8 people replied. So we messaged like 10 people yesterday. Some of them haven't replied now. And this is actually quite a good rate on people that actually reply. For me, I've typically found out that about half of the influencers, or more than half the influencers that you message, will never reply to you. Like, never reply to you. Not even after 24 hours. So it's good that most of the influencers I messaged yesterday replied. And now we want to go through them one by one and see how much they're offering, how much they're charging, and then we start negotiating with them. So always we want to remember that we never pay sticker price. We never pay how much that they're asking us to pay. We always negotiate. Even if the price is super good, you want to negotiate with them, okay? Now, especially as a beginner, you don't have much money and you want to make sure that the shout out is going to do very well. So you want to go ahead and make sure you're not spending that much on ads when it comes to testing. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and open the first DM from Awesome Life That Hacks. So first thing I do is check the price. So they're charging one post $15, a story $10, one post and story $20. So normally influencers offer deals like that when you buy a story. If you remember what I mentioned in the last video, you shouldn't buy stories when you're testing products. Now, just personally, I haven't found stories that effective. I've tested it with UTM links on Google, and I found out even on my top products, about 1 in 50 people would buy it from a feed post, but when the traffic was coming from a story, it's so low quality, so spammy. It's an easy call to action, basically. Low quality traffic always swipes up, and the conversion rate was like 0.5 percent. So it's pretty rubbish. I wouldn't buy conversion a story, even if it's only a $5 extra. I wouldn't buy it. And you also see that they're offering link in bio. Now, I see so many other YouTubers saying that you should always buy all three or get link in bio just because people will click that link in their bio. But I would always recommend you purchase a promo that sends people directly to your bio. So let's say if you're consistently buying a link in bio on their page, then you'll never actually grow the followers on your own Instagram page. And one of the main benefits about growing the followers on your Instagram page is that on Facebook ads, you can go ahead and retarget the people that visited your page. So let's say if we do get like a 1,000 people visiting our profile from this shout out, then we can go ahead and retarget those people on Facebook and make money back. But we can't retarget people that visited, you know, the profile of this awesome life.hacks. So I would always recommend you send people to your page. Again, you build up those custom audiences that you can later build into lookalike audiences and very cool stuff with that on Facebook. But we're not going to get into that yet. But again, just listen to me for the time being. You should always connect. You should always not buy link in bio on another person's page. So let's go and check out how much they're making. So I think someone posted an ad there actually. Okay, so this ad actually got 182,000 views on this page. They're charging $15. So 182,000. Oh, that's actually quite good. They probably made maybe like 5-10 sales from this. They probably made $100 from it. I'm just assuming that based off the views, because typically I find that 10 to 20k views means one sale. So based on those numbers, I would assume that. But for this product, the engagement, only 68 comments. So that not that many comments. So it might not be too good. But let's just scroll through their feed and check if everything is all okay in terms of views. They're getting pretty consistent views. Yes. 100k, 77k, 160k. Okay, so that all looks pretty good. 140k. Okay, so $15 and they're getting 200k views. That is actually pretty decent. I might go ahead and test on this page actually, because $15 is not that much. If we look at our break-even point, which is basically the profit margin on the teeth whitening pen, we actually made a $16 profit margin. Now, I told you guys in the previous video, $16 is like the perfect amount for me after after the transaction fees and the payment processing fees and stuff like that. It comes out to $15. But basically, we need to make one sale from this page in order to break even. And if we do break even, then it shows us the product has potential and we can go ahead and scale it. So actually, this would be a good page to test on. So I'm going to go ahead and message them. And again, like I said, we always want to negotiate. Even if the price is super good, I think $15 is pretty decent. You always want to negotiate. You don't want to negotiate like be super annoying when you negotiate, but just say this is what I say. So I said, let's do it. So because this is such a significant amount, we probably can't bring it down by $5 because the seller will be like, hey, this is definitely worth $15 anyway. So when it's such a good deal, you don't want to miss out on it. So I would just say let's do it for this one. You guys might do like let's do for $14 or $13, but because like $1 or $2 couldn't really matter that much at this point. I mean, it is quite a bit of our budget. I don't really mind. I just want to get this deal set up so it's ready for tomorrow. So let's say let's do it. Let's do a feed post. Send your PayPal. I can pay ASAP. And just like that, he'll send over his PayPal. And then we can go ahead and post on this page. So hopefully this guy will reply to us. I know sometimes people send really good prices and they don't end up replying to you, which is not good. But it just happens anyway, so you have to deal with it. And let's do that emoji. And then what we also want to do is we want to save that page. So we go here and then we click. This option is not on the account. This is kind of weird. But basically, when you scroll swipe right, sometimes there's an option that comes up saying flag and allows you to flag the account. So maybe it's at the top here. Flag. No, I can't flag the account. So if I flagged it, then it would just basically show me in the future that that's a pretty good account to go buy from. But yeah, that might be a solid account. So we'll go ahead and flag that. Universal Sale Tech. Hi there, post buy on soy will be £20. Okay, so some people do ask you to pay in different currencies. Obviously, pound is my currency. But if you guys were in the US and you wouldn't really understand pound, so just go ahead and type into Google pound to dollars. And that's about $25 for post, bio, link, and story. And again, most people, most influencers offer all three of those in one. So go ahead and check their feed. Okay, someone else posted it. And 124,000 views for the teeth whitening pen. Whoa, loads of people are actually posting this pen. It must be doing super good. And 161k. Everything is pretty consistent here. So I would look into buying from them. I say fire, let's do a feed post. Now again, when it comes to buying from viral pages, I don't have a specific amount I would pay pages. They have 95,000 followers, so I would say, let's look at the ad, okay? So they probably made maybe 2 or 3 sales on this ad, so at least $50 back. So anything really under $50 for a page on the $50 for a post on this page is good, and they're only charging £20, so it's anyways going to be profitable if you know this product is living up to expectations that the conversion rates I do expect it to live up to. But I would still negotiate. I say let's do a feed post only, and then say no story or link in bio, and really anything you can get under £20 is good. But I would say let's make it £15. Maybe you can push it to 10, but he might not accept it. But let's keep it at 15, okay? And then send your PayPal. So that's like $20, which means we need 2 sales to break even. And I assume based off the engagement that this ad got, then you probably can get 2 sales on it. So let's do send your PayPal. And then he'll go ahead and send his PayPal. And after the test, which we're most likely doing on the other page that we just found, awesomelife.hack, we'll go ahead, and if it is selling well, we might even scale it on Universal Sale Tech by posting there as well. So basically, scaling is when you post it on multiple pages and you get loads of people posting it, and it basically boosts the amount of sales you are making. So let's go. And one thing might want to know is that some pages, or most pages, actually own multiple pages. So let's say if you, the owner of, okay, so one sec, this person has actually replied with their PayPal. So they send their PayPal email. And we're going to say, great, paying soon. So what I would go ahead and do is just go ahead and send this guy a payment. And then we will, I'm not going to show you how to send it on PayPal. It's pretty straightforward how you can send payments on PayPal. But you just copy and paste this email. You click send by goods and services. And you always want to make sure it's goods and services. Because if it's not, then people can scam you. If it's friends and family, people can just take your money and walk away. They never reply to you again. Make sure it's goods and services. Send them $15. And then I'll show you how you do that in the next video, and we'll just go ahead and set up the post. But yeah, let's just save this somewhere. So we'll go put it in the notes section, notes, and then we put it here, and then we put awesomelife.hack, and then test. So that meaning that we go ahead and test this page. So let's go back here, and what I was saying was most page owners, people who own one page tend to own multiple pages because, you know, Instagram is kind of like their business and they want to grow their business, so they buy more pages. So if this page or a page just performed good, then you can go ahead and ask the seller if they own any or more pages that you could potentially buy shoutouts from. And most likely people own multiple pages, like I said, so they'll send you the rates for their other pages as well. And you can find good pages by doing that as well, because if they own one page, they probably own more quality pages like that. Not necessarily, but more likely, because it just shows that the seller is good, and you can buy promos from them on a regular basis on both their pages, and you get like a discounted price, because when you buy it on two pages, the seller is getting more money, so they'll kind of give you a discount, most likely, normally. And yeah, let's reply to a few more. So viral one videos, thanks for interest. 24-hour post costs €10, okay, that's a euro sign, so I believe a euro is like $1.2, so that's like $13, 12 hours, 6 hours, $6. Okay, so like I said, you guys, for viral video posts, you always want to be posting for 24 hours or permanent posts. The reason I do that is because the explore page kind of works in a way where only after the first really 8 hours does content get pushed onto the explore page. When it comes to posting on meme pages and quote pages, then I would only buy 8 hour posts because those tend to work better. So let's check the engagement here, viral one videos. 240k, 877, 76, 150, 300. Okay, this is also a very good page. Not that consistent, to be honest. Other pages were quite consistent. This one's getting kind of iffy content, 67 here. So I would go ahead and €10 is actually quite a good price for this page. I would say fire. We'll start with fire emojis so you can catch your attention. And just always start with fire emoji basically. Let's do a 24-hour feed post only for, and I would say maybe €8. Okay, and then send your PayPal. You always want to end with send your PayPal because you can like close the deal immediately, and you want to close the deal as soon as possible. So let's go send your PayPal. Click send and close that. And Earth Universe. $20 for a feed post. So let's click Us Universe. Go ahead and check out Us Universe. $20 for a feed post. We'll link it by 30 hours. Okay, so that's kind of random, 30 hours. But let's go ahead and check that out anyway. So we go scroll through their feed. 84K, 13K. Okay, so that immediately tells me that they're kind of inconsistent. Or 79, 290, 600K. Okay, that's quite high, you know. 600K, 200K is quite high. 400K. Okay, so this page is gained quite high engagement, 600k, whoa, but like the most recent post hasn't done good. So one thing you might notice with these viral pages is that all their posts before, like from 2 days ago, get like 100k, 200k, 300 views, 200k views, and then the posts in the last 2 days have only got 10, 20k views. What this immediately tells you is that this page is shadow banned. So what a shadow ban basically is, and it's kind of a complicated concept to understand, but basically if a page does something wrong or they have content taken down, Instagram will go ahead and ban that page for 2 days. So what happens, in that 2 week ban, what happens is that page can't promote any of its content onto the Explore page. So anything that it posts won't be really shown to its followers. It will only be shown to like a selected few amount of people. So typically when you post an ad on a shadow ban page, it won't go very well because not many people see the post. If you post it when it's not shadow banned, then it'll go ahead and go viral again. But if it's shadow banned, then I wouldn't buy from it. So if it, a good indicator is to see that if it has no views in the last day that also was posted, this page is probably shadow banned. So I'm not going to post on it. We're just going to leave it for the time being. And Universal Sale Tech responded. It looks like they've accepted it. So we're going to go ahead and put that on our sections as well. We'll put Universal Sale Tech, Universal Sale Tech, and then we go scale. So test means we're going to test on that page. Scale means if the product works, we'll scale on that page. So let's just go through the last ones that we have. What should I post? Okay, so some people ask, what am I posting? I would say ad is for a teeth whitening pen, and then check my feed. So she should have posted it by now. Check my feed, and then he'll go ahead, check my feed, he can see the ad, and yeah. Why is this video still not loaded? I have no idea why. But yeah, our feed is looking pretty clean right now. Just waiting for that video to load. Anyway, let's go ahead and message to check a few last ones. Only feed posts or without link in bio? Yeah, so fire, feed posts only. Feed posts only, you want to only be buying feed posts. Unless if someone says they offer a free link in bio or story, you might as well take it. But normally when they say free, they probably include it in the price in the feed post, which is like kind of like a marketing trick you guys would understand. So you want to still go ahead and negotiate the price even further, saying, I don't want your free story or link in bio, give me a cheap price. And it does work, but feed posts only, and then send rates. Let's go ahead. You have PayPal? Yes. Right, yes. Send rates. Some people will just reply without their rates. You want to go ahead and answer any questions they do have, show them your product, and then get them to send their prices once again. So Arts of Society, hi, thank you for your interest. Permanent post is $9. For our post, link in bio is $8. Oh, so as you can see here, they're offering permanent posts, which is probably what we want to buy, and it's only $1 more expensive than the 24-hour post. So you know that's quite good. So we want to probably buy the permanent post if the page is good. Let's just scroll through and check what the page was. Ah, I remember this page. This was the page I was getting super viral engagement on their post. I believe, where was the ad? The ad was all the way back down there. 300k on this ad, and before we saw another ad, it got 151k. Okay, so that shows potential. That shows that this page is quite good, and they only charge $9. So that's actually quite good. So let's go ahead and say, fire, send your PayPal. Let's do it. So that is a pretty solid page. Now I might even test on this page instead. I normally don't test on two different pages, but because Awesome Life Hack was a pretty good page, and Art of Society is looking like a good page, I might test on both of them actually. So I might go ahead and PayPal both of them today, once they send their PayPal emails, and we might go test the product on both of them. But we'll leave that as that for now. So those two are definitely very good two deals, and Universal Sale Tech is kind of a bit expensive, but literally guys, you can easily test products for $9, $10, like I was saying. Just by finding pages like awesomelife.hack and Arts of Society, you can find pretty good deals on them. Artist.cloud. Let's check how many likes they're getting. 12,000 likes, 24,000 followers. That's pretty good. Views, 66,000. Not that many. 11,000. That's not that many at all. this is a pretty rubbish engagement. Their photos are going kind of viral, which is good to see, but their videos aren't going viral. And we're going to be posting a video out. So regardless of how many views, likes a photo is getting, if videos aren't doing good, then you shouldn't be buying video on that page. Because as you can see here, the maximum it's getting is 50k views. So let's just go ahead and $40 for a post feature. So immediately, no, we're just going to leave that there. There's no way you're going to negotiate that person less than $30, really. So I wouldn't really even bother messaging them back. Because $40 is ridiculously high when it comes to the amount of money that we do have. We only have $100. We need to test products with that, and we need to scale products with that. So I would also recommend you keep on reinvesting your profits back into the business. So let's say if the sale, we do get a few sales from the test on those two pages, we'll go ahead and take that money and put it back into shoutouts so we can consistently scale this product upwards and upwards. And if we only make, let's say we make one sale and we need two to break even, we'll go ahead and take the money from the one sale and test a new product, and hopefully that will work as well. So Beautiful Minds cost $10. Let's see how many posts they're getting. 10k views, 100k views. Pretty rubbish, actually. 136, 195. Not that good, actually. Some of it goes viral, some of it doesn't. That's kind of like one of those iffy pages I was talking about. Let's say, I would say $5, okay? Send your PayPal. Let's do a feed post only for $5. $10, we still might be profitable because we only need one sale to break even and still make profit. But let's just say $5 because that's more appropriate, $5. And then I'm pretty sure we reply to everyone. Let's go. I also streamed the video tonight. Is the same video. Streamed. Is the same. It will be a clickbait video. And I saved the video to my phone, so I'm going to go ahead and send them the video. I saved it there. So let's just send them that video. And this is like the viral clickbait videos. And with the cover photo, it's kind of like disgusting, but still, it gets people to watch. And then we say fire, always fire emojis. Let me know when, and then because obviously when you check out here, you want them to see the fire emoji like I'm seeing them. So fire, let me know, and then has he sent this? Oh yeah, he sent this by. So send your PayPal. Always push to get the PayPal. And then that is basically how you negotiate with Instagram influencers. You're never really paying the sticker price, the price that they're offering. You're always looking to negotiate with them. And you also want to check the engagement and then base that off how much you're willing to pay. Always look at if they've posted any other ads on their feed. If the ads on their feed have done good, you can pretty much work out. I'd say go by the ratio of if a video gets 30k views, it has one sale. So if you see an ad on someone's page that has 100,000 views, you can assume it got maybe 3 or 4 sales, which basically means that, let's say if your profit margin is $15 like mine, then you could probably pay up to $60 for a post on that page, which is quite good. So let's go ahead and finish this video by finding a few more pages that we could potentially post on. So this is what I do every single day. I'm always looking for new pages to post on, because if we keep on using the old pages, we don't contact any new pages, and we keep recycling the old pages, eventually those will die out. So no bio link needed. So we'll go ahead and check our explore page like we did yesterday and find a few more new pages. And I would recommend you find 20, 30, 40 new pages every single day that you could negotiate with and post on. So let's go and refresh this and let's go come here. Let's see. That has 20k views, 40k views, 30k views. 300k, okay, I'm going to DM them just because they have 20,000 followers, which means they probably charge little to nothing for a post. Let's quickly storm through this. 500k views, 184, let's go DM these guys. And I'm going to make this real quick so that you guys don't have to watch all of it. And just like that, we've maxed out the amount of pages that we can DM in 1 hour. And that pretty much wraps up this video, so actually, no, we're going to jump into the main section now. But anyway, that wraps up the negotiation section for this video. The next part will be the updates I've made on the store. And I would go ahead and do this thing, DMing people about 2-3 times a day once the hourly limit is maxed. So if you do it 2-3 times a day, I know it takes 5 minutes each. You probably get 60 pages messaged every single day, and you probably have 20 of them reply to you the next day, and you might get like 5 deals set up every single day. So obviously if you want to do this at scale, you want, and you want more than 5 deals set up a day in the scaling process, you want like 20 deals a day. So you would have to spend way more time doing this. But again, it's kind of not that hard, and it's pretty straightforward to do. So guys, I hope you did enjoy this section, and let's move on to the store update section of the video. Okay guys, so what I want to do real quick is give you a quick update on what I've done since the last time I recorded the video, and I made a few changes to the website, but nothing much. I'll quickly explain it to you. So first of all, what I did was I installed the currency converter app by Orgeting or whatever that is. And the reason I did that is because the old one wasn't exactly working, and it costs about $3 a month. And again, we're on a $100 budget. And this is something I keep on emphasizing throughout the series, is that you should not be spending money on irrelevant stuff. You shouldn't be spending on apps. You shouldn't be spending it on other emails, other programs, stuff like that. You guys are like spending money on stuff that are not relevant. You should only be saving up your money when it comes to marketing, because marketing is the main thing you want to master. And once you've mastered the marketing, then you can go ahead and spend money on whatever you want, as long as you're making profit out of it. So this one's free and it's actually working, which is good. So I just quickly went to the App Store, and I recommend you guys get that one as well, because it connects to whatever location a person is in. So if I'm in the US, all my prices will be displayed in USD, which is good because the other ones normally charge. So I went ahead and made that change. What I also did is I'm going to contact Shopify support to figure out how to get rid of this little section over here. If you guys remember, in day one, I thought that this section would automatically disappear, because it did happen last time. But again, the Shopify support are super helpful, and about this time of day, no one is up in the US, so I'm going to be like the first one on the chat. So we're going to sort that out as well real quick. And also, I went ahead and clicked legal in the settings tab over here. We're in the setting, click legal, and I forgot to do this in day one of store creation, but we were meant to create templates for the refund policy, privacy policy, and terms of service. So this is like auto-generated from Shopify. It basically just states, you know, refund policy, you know, 30 days and stuff, privacy policy, that's GDPR compliant, and a load of other stuff like that. So that was basically all the changes I've made. And then one thing I forgot to mention was actually how to set up navigation inside of Shopify. So again, this won't take long. You guys just need to do exactly what I'm doing. So when you click navigation on the online store, you see main menu here. And main menu is basically the menu that goes across the top of your store. So what you want to do is you want to click there, and then you want to add something to the menu. So normally I click add menu item. I go best sellers. And I want people directly to link to my best sellers. Like, I see some people linking to their other pages, like the refund page, the FAQs and stuff like that. But I wouldn't recommend doing that, just because, I mean, I wouldn't recommend putting them in front of the best sellers list, because if you have a home and then best sellers right next to each other, then people are more likely to click best sellers and go buy something. But if you have home and a refund policy, then people aren't as likely to go and buy something. So that's why I just put best sellers there. And then we're going to do collections, and then we do all collections, and we'll just leave it as that, and we'll click add. And then we want to get rid of catalog, because that's basically, it shows all our collection pages. Then what we want to do is we want to go to refund policy, and then we want to link to our refund policy. So I believe we click pages, no, it's not that, policies, yep, and then refund policy. We'll click that, and then we want to do FAQs. So I'm going to show you guys how I quickly put together an FAQ. I'll actually leave it in the description box below. If you click that link to the Google Docs file, I'll copy and paste the FAQs that I normally put on my websites. And I just use the same ones over again, because that's the general questions we end up getting. But I'm going to quickly blur out my screen, because I'm going to copy and paste it from my other store. But it's essentially the same thing that you should be doing for this one. So guys, I went ahead to the pages section. I copy and pasted the contact us, FAQs, and shipping delivery from my other store into this one. And then I'm going to go back to navigation right here. And then we click add menu item. Then we go FAQs. And then we click pages here. Click FAQs. And then add. And then we do the same for contact us. Pages. Contact us. Ta-da. And then the final one is shipping and delivery. So do that. And we go here. And you guys, there is some text relating to my store on there, so you want to change it up when I give you the template of what to write. But it basically essentially tells people, shipping delivery tells people how long it takes for the item to come. I'm sure I've mentioned it in the last video, but basically, if you're not upfront with people telling them that their item will take 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks to get there, then they won't be likely to buy from you. You'll actually have a high conversion rate if you're straight up and you tell them how long it will take. If you don't tell them whatsoever, or you don't tell them whatsoever, then you're kind of like, they get a dodgy feeling that, hey, these people aren't even telling me, or even the emails, and they feel kind of not a sense of connection and trust with you. But if you tell them upfront, then they're more likely to buy from you. That's what I personally felt. And plus, you don't want to be misleading. You don't want to like sort of tell them that, give them the impression that it might arrive in like 2-3 days, when in fact it takes 2-3 weeks. So I don't want to be misleading. That's why we directly put it there. I also mentioned that it comes from China and it comes from a warehouse. But again, we're not misleading. If something does come from the US, so we put on the product itself that it comes from the US, and that's actually a selling point because people like stuff that come from the US. But yeah, I'm right up front on the shipping delivery page where the stuff comes from and everything. So we want to rearrange this in a place and a way that makes us the most amount of money as possible. So home should always be there, of course. Bestsellers should always be next. Like I mentioned, you want people to buy, so you want bestsellers to be next. And then refund policy, I would also put here. The reason I do that is because when people shop online and they have like that sense of, should I buy, should I not? They normally look for a refund policy page on your website to see what your policy is like. And if they, you know, they're convinced by your refund policy, then they'll go ahead and buy. So you want to make that easy for them to find and put it right near the front. And then FAQs is like the things that are stopping people from buying. So if you address these questions immediately, they're more likely to buy. So I always put FAQs there. Contact us is like, if they have any questions about your products, or like they have a question about their order, then they go ahead and contact you. And again, that could result in more sales. So I basically put it in a way that makes us the most amount of sales possible. So homepage, like that has to be first anyway. Bestsellers, you know, that makes us the most amount of sales. Then it's refunds, then it's FAQs, then it's contact us. And then the shipping and delivery won't make us sales. People just having questions. We'll look at shipping and delivery. And of course, we do mention China and stuff on there, so we want to keep it kind of near the back as well. But yeah, shipping and delivery. And then there is one app that I would recommend you guys get as you're making orders. So I won't get it right now just because I'm not making orders. But once the store hits 1K, then you definitely need to check out getting this app. And if you go to the app store right here, it's called Order Tracking or Trackify or something like that. Let me go ahead and type up Order Tracking. And the one I use is the Tracker. Yeah, Tracker's the app. And what it basically does is it's like this app that you install on your website, I mean your Shopify store. And then as soon as you install it, it will ask you to create a page called Track My Order. Now you can add this Track My Order page to the navigation over here. And when you add it to navigation, basically whenever anyone clicks on it, they can go ahead and type in their order number. So like if someone like placed an order, and their order number is like 1005, they go ahead and type that order number into the section on your website, and it will go ahead and track their order for them and tell them exactly where their order is. And it's basically a neat integration that you can have on your Shopify store so that people can actually track the order, and you have way less chargebacks and refunds because people have that secure, safe feeling that they can actually check where their order is anywhere, anytime. So obviously this video is about Instagram influencer negotiating, so we'll quickly close that. And sorry I didn't mention that in the first video, but let's go on and contact the Shopify support team and show you guys how you can download that app. I mean, get rid of that section on our Shopify store that at the very front that's making the site look not that clean. Obviously, not many people visit our front page, but we want to make it look clean for the people that do. So remove section on site. I'm going to skip through this so you guys can see how easy this is. Meantime, actually, we'll go ahead and do a few more things just because we obviously can't do this. So let's go back to the website and let's set up our upsells. So I'm pretty sure we did not do that on the first video. So again, the product that we'll be testing is a teeth whitening pen, and we're going to go ahead, maybe I'm going to move this to the end of the video, but we're going to set up an upsell for the product. So we'll go ahead and we go to settings, I believe. Create your first upsell offer. So the one that we got was in-cart upsell, just again because it was free. So we're going to create your first upsell offer. So typically what I find is that people tend to buy the same item that they just bought after purchase. So this is with an app called One Click Upsell, and I'm not going to tell you guys much about the app at the moment because you guys don't need to know anything about it. Maybe in an advanced training video or in the future I'll talk about it. Before post-purchase, you want to sell them something different. So after purchase, if you sell them the same thing again, they're more likely to buy. But before purchase, if they added the teeth whitening pen to cart, then you want to sell them something related but different, and they're more likely to buy that than the same item again. So we're going to go ahead and so let's call this teeth whitening upsell and products offered. So that's why I imported a other products onto the website on the first day, just because I could upsell people on those offers as well. So I found out that the charcoal, and I've seen this product before, but the charcoal teeth whitener looks like a pretty good product because it was getting a ton of sales on AliExpress. It had over like 50,000 orders, and I've seen loads of stores selling that pretty successfully. So charcoal teeth whitening, then we click order and text. So we want to upsell people the most popular product. And obviously we can split test it, we can run two different offers at the same time and see which one people are buying. And a perfect app to do that is actually Zipify one-click upsell. You can split test if this offer is working better or this offer is working better and how much you're making per visitor. And it's kind of complicated to explain now, but on these three apps, you can't exactly see that stuff. We'll go ahead and offer this item first. Offer look and feel, and yeah, we'll just leave that as it is. Compact color scheme, we'll leave that is small because we don't want to make the screen too big. Then we go ahead and click add rule, and then we want to do cart contains at least one of teeth or whitening pen. So that means if someone has at least one teeth whitening pen on their cart, then they will go ahead and show the upsell of the other product to them. So don't show offer after it's continued. Advanced settings. When they send people directly to checkout, because that will obviously boost their conversion rate. If you send people to shopping cart, and I've seen this tested, when you send people directly to checkout, you're more likely to convert them than sending them to add to cart page and then the checkout. Because you want to make your checkout process as quick as possible. So that's why we have dynamic checkout buttons on our website. So someone can directly go from the product page to the checkout page. If you add that extra step in, which is going to add to cart page, as obviously some people need the add to cart page because they might go around and buy different items or multiple items, but for most traffic, then sending them directly to checkout page is way more conversion optimizing. When offer is updated, we're gonna go discounts. We're gonna click create a 10% offer for our upsells, just because I found that converts pretty good. So we go to discounts, click discount code, and then we do special 10. Or sometimes I do something like happy customer 10. And the reason I do happy customer 10 is that just by writing happy customer, they tend to become a happy customer. It's kind of the philosophy I heard. I mean, I didn't make that up, but I've heard someone else say it. So I just use happy customer 10 and then applies to entire order. We're doing it to specific products, just the upsell, which is the charcoal. So if you click to the entire order, what it basically does is it takes 10% off the teeth whitening pen and the charcoal teeth whitener. But if you do it just for the charcoal teeth whitener, then it just takes it off that one and not the other. So none here, everyone, that's fine. That's fine. And click save. And then let's copy this and put it in here. Apply. And then we click save. Publish this and save offer, and we're just going to walk through and check if it is working fine. So let's go there and let's go to, where was it, teeth whitening, and we sell this, and as you guys can see, it's converting the right currency now, and right ending and stuff. So when you click add to cart, it should display, yeah, would you like to add a charcoal teeth whitener, and then it adds here, add to cart. When we click it, then it should automatically send us to checkout, and you see it's taken the 10% off. Happy customer, that's just what we wanted. I may look, again, the color scheme was meant to be blue and white, so I'm gonna change that to blue and white because I don't like it. So look and feel, color scheme, let's go to, let's see what that looks like. Charcoal teeth whitener. Okay, that's turquoise, but I don't like that turquoise. Let's just play around with this a bit. Shopify support, we're 29, so still good. Always be productive, always doing stuff whilst that stuff is going on. Original, save offer. Always play around with it, see what fits your theme. Like I said in the last video, you want to have a specific theme to your website. You don't want to have stuff, loads of different colors, random colors. all that. Okay, I like this green. I'm just going to leave it as green. I'm not sure how to customize it into blue. And we won't waste time on that because, like I said, you want to be spending as much time as possible learning about marketing and getting the marketing nailed. So we'll just leave that as it is. And then we're going to go ahead and wait till the Shopify support team actually get back to us. So one thing we actually want to do is find some quality content that we go ahead and post on our Instagram page. And I've talked about it in a previous video, like I said, but you want to arrange your Instagram page in a way that makes people trust it and more likely to buy. And oh, lost connection. Don't tell me lost connection. I've been waiting for ages. But anyway, you want to make your Instagram page super reliable and look super legit. So I'm going to show you guys how you can find good content to post on your page and how much content you should be posting roughly when it comes to a product. Okay, so let's go ahead and find some content that we can post on our page with a teeth whitening pen. So let's just close that. And we're going to go to Instagram. And then we'll check our explore page, see if anything's there. 38th in the queue? What? I swear we were like 20th last time. Okay, anyway. So what we want to do is we want to scroll down. I think we already found one. Let's just...
This new U-Beauty whitening pen is super cool, super easy to use. I keep one in my car. All you do is pop the lid off, and then you twist the bottom, and then you just have...
Well, that was easy. Okay, we went ahead and found one video already. So we're just going to click download button here. So this is the Instagram Chrome extension, and it lets you easily download videos and stuff like that. So then we'll go ahead and email it to ourselves. So let me just blur this bit out. We went ahead and attached that file, and let's find a few more to post on our Instagram page. So typically I'm looking between 4-6 pictures or videos I can post on my Instagram page to promote the product, just because if we have one, then it looks too plain. If I have two, then also a bit too plain. And we can actually have more than six, because the more the better. But yeah, six is fine, so 36. Okay, let's keep on looking. So we found one that easy. Maybe this is one. No, that's not one. And we're just finding something like that teeth whitening ad that we just saw there. This one. No, that's not one. So this is one way to do it. Another way to do it is actually visiting that store that we just saw and checking out what they've posted on their page, because they must be making money from it. Okay, so we'll go ahead and take one of these videos, pictures, so how to use, we'll take that. And we'll also take this, because this looks clean. We'll use that. So we'll go ahead and attach those two emails as well, two files as well. So we went ahead and attached those as well. Let's find a few more. We're still 35th in the queue. Come on, it's never taking this long. Unbelievable. Okay, so we check that store out. So let's find a different store that's selling it and then go ahead and check their feed as well. And maybe we can find some good content for it. So this might be it. Get a teeth whitener also. So so many people are promoting this, I've noticed. So this must be like a really good product, because I'm seeing this ad quite a lot. New day brushes. Okay, so they don't actually post images of the product. They just post lifestyle images. We'll go ahead and post a lifestyle image. Which one has the most likes? If it has the most likes, then it's probably doing good. 700, 1,900. If it has the most likes, then it's doing good. So go ahead and post one with the most likes. I believe the one with the most likes at the very top there with 1,000 something likes. Which one was it? It was this one. So we'll go ahead and keep this, because we don't want to post too many. Actually, we might get one more, which has the second most likes. 1.1k. I think this one has the second most likes. We'll go ahead and post that as well, because that looks like it's doing pretty good as pictures related to lifestyle. And I've mentioned this before again, you want to have lifestyle images on your page ideally, or on your Instagram page at least, because lifestyle images actually show people using your product or looking like they're using their product actually. And that helps boost your conversion rate, because people can kind of visualize what the product will look like when they get it. So let's find two or three more that we can post on our page, so that we can make sure our Instagram profile is like completely complete. So let's click here. I believe this is one that's a pore cleaner, and we're not going to work on that at the moment. We're just testing the teeth whitening. We're seeing this ad quite a bit, so I'm going to go ahead and save that. Because for later, we always want to find new products like this. So let's say if this teeth whitening item does not work, then we'll go ahead and test the next item that we find. And as we scroll through our explore page, we keep on finding more and more items. We just click save and we come back to them in the future if we have nothing to test, we're not selling anything, and we want to test a new item. Because you want to consistently be finding the next big thing that you can go ahead and sell. You don't want to be living off one whole trend for like 6 months, which is something I did super wrong when I first started Shopify. For the first 6 months of 2018, I pretty much sold the same item, and I expected that to like be consistent, but I wasn't actually testing new items. But now I realize you have to test new items to be making more money, so that's what I'm doing now. So I always keep new items there. So let's see if I find anything else. So I found another one on Peak Monk's profile, and the video doesn't look too bad. So we went ahead and download that. And we saved this video as well, because that's a potential product that we can test in the future. And let's find one more video to pretty much wrap this one up. And again, guys, another way you can find winning products literally by scrolling through someone's Instagram feed. I mean, if you scroll through their page, then you can find out all the other products that they've tested. They posted in the past, and they must be making money from the products if they have thousands of likes. So this one only has 73 likes, so it probably didn't make them much money. But if you click here, the Rose languages thing, that didn't make much money. This got 3k likes, so it probably made some amount of money. And just like that, if you scroll through their page, you can see what's making money, what's not making money based on the likes it is getting. But let's go ahead and find one more video. Okay, that one looks pretty good, so we'll go ahead and download that as well. And that pretty much, that's basically all the downloads we need. So I downloaded quite a few. Let's go ahead and add them to the email. So we went ahead and attached all those images, and then we just click send, and then I'll get it on my phone, and we'll go ahead and show you how to post it. One thing you also want to consider to do, and I probably should blow out this whole screen here so you see all my emails, but the one thing we should also consider to do is getting a caption for our Instagram. We want to have a professional constructed caption so we can maximize the amount of sales that we are getting. Now, I normally have a template that I recommend to use for captions, and that is basically when you list a product name and then you say, wow, this is amazing. Then we go ahead and say, mega 50% off, link in, and then tag our page. Then we say, free worldwide shipping, limited offer. And then we tag our page again, and then we say, tag someone who needs this. And that's like the engaging way I normally post ads and captions on my page and other pages. But we're going to go ahead and see what other people are doing, because if other people are making a ton of sales, then their caption is probably selling pretty well. So go ahead and take inspiration from their captions. We're not exactly going to steal it, because we obviously have we have to change it up to match, make it match our theme. Let's go ahead and find the ad one more time. So there's another one there. We all know someone who needs this. So that's not the teeth whitening, so we'll just leave that. Is this the teeth whitening? No, that's not the teeth whitening. There's quite a few ads. We all know someone who needs this. Don't you wish you had white teeth? Grab yours ad. Okay, this one looks pretty good. Actually, before we copy this, we want to check if they're actually making money. So 6,000 followers. Okay, so this is a bit.ly. Like, this is actually really good. I'm glad I came across this. So whilst we're still 24th in the queue, let me explain to you something really cool about bit.ly links. So if you type copy and paste a bit.ly link, one thing that you guys probably don't know that you could do is if you click the plus right next to it, type in plus, you see like I did plus. And this also works with Google links, you know, geo shortened links, basically. Click plus, click enter. What you can do is you can see all the stats for this specific product, this specific link. So you can go ahead and see where the link clicks came from to the exact dot. This is like the exact statistics that the people are getting inside of their actual bit.ly accounts. Then you can see where the traffic came from. You can see it came from Instagram influencers primarily. And you can see what country it came from. And you can see all this different stuff. And it's really helpful because it tells you if the product is actually selling or not. So they got about 470 clicks today. It's the 22nd. We started this challenge 4 days ago, so they probably didn't make that many sales, to be honest. They probably made like 4 or 5 sales, but a good conversion rate, maybe up to 10. But that doesn't look too good, so maybe they aren't selling pretty well. So I might just look for a store that's selling quite good, and that will tell us to copy their caption instead. But go ahead and actually take theirs, just in case that they are selling well, and maybe they just recently inserted this bit.ly link. So go ahead and send this to ourselves. And yeah, we obviously need to change this to make it match our bio. Unless if you want to promote another person's store and make them a ton of money. Let's go look for some more captions. You can see basically everything I'm doing inside of this challenge series is pretty straightforward, pretty simple. As soon as you nail the basics and you get the basics over, and then you stop overcomplicating. Like, people overcomplicate things. They try to add in their own twist to it. They try to do this different, that different. But if you can keep it simple, do exactly what I'm doing and you'll be making money, because Shopify isn't that hard. It's just that people make it hard when they try to overcomplicate the way that they do things. Let's just go ahead and look some more. Finally, Shopify. So we were finding captions, but it looks like Shopify decided to come. So let's go ahead and type in "hey there." And again, guys, they're pretty helpful. They'll get this sorted for you real quick. So don't worry, Shopify has got your back. Let me just wait for them to reply. We find another caption real quick so that we're not wasting time. We hate to waste time, so let's go double tap. Okay, we'll go ahead and copy this and maybe check if they're making sales by going to their profile. 5,000 followers. We'll go ahead and copy it and we'll just leave it as it is for now. And we'll go ahead and send this to ourselves and we might go ahead and use one of these captions when we're testing the product today. You can see that it's spelled teeth whitening wrong. Now, I have actually heard that concept before. You're intentionally getting spelling wrong inside the ad copy. And what that basically does is it sparks engagement in the comments saying, you know, like people addressing us directly saying, "Hey, you got this spelling mistake in your caption wrong. Change it," or like they're saying, if you get something inside the image wrong, then they say, "Hey, you got this bit wrong, this bit isn't edited properly," and they go ahead and it sparks those comments below, and it basically helps build engagement and actually helps sell your product, in fact. So sometimes it's good to have purposeful spelling errors inside your ad copy. I haven't fully looked into it, but I heard that does help in some ways. So I'm just gonna correct it anyway, we'll just send it to ourselves. We'll go back to the Shopify support team, yeah. Winning item 2017, I believe. I might talk about stuff like this in future videos. It's basically when you ship the product back to yourself so you can create custom content for it. This was like a year ago when I was selling these music boxes and they were doing pretty well. And I was shipping the actual music box here. It's got like 10,000 orders on AliExpress, I believe. For my listing, that is, I believe I sold around 10,000 of these, and once I realized I was selling these pretty well, I went ahead and shipped them to me so I could create custom for content for it. I believe we did over maybe 200,000 in sales on this product alone, which is pretty good, but they had a couple variants, obviously, the other variants sold as well. It's pretty good. And then when I finished with the product, I just sent it to someone. Gave it away to a friend, really. I just had one there. Finally, they replied, "I'm in your female husband, and looks like the slide. Do you definitely want to have images?" Yes, guys, you definitely do not want to have images. Yes. Definitely no images. Please. And they will go ahead and follow your command. If not, I can pass a theme to remove the code. Or let's just see what she's talking about. Themes. Ah, there we go. Pretty simple. Save. Perfecto. Done. That was pretty simple. You should have just done that. And then when we visit the store, it should get rid of that. Yes, just like that. I'm a genius now. Nah, I'm going to say thank you. Like I said, these guys are epic, they're like geniuses, so thank you a lot. So we're going to jump into my phone right now. I probably moved this section to the end of the video, but yeah. Okay guys, so that pretty much wraps up this video. I pretty much showed you guys all the site changes that I made, and then I showed you guys how to go over Instagram influencers, how to negotiate with them, how to set up the first deal. So I'll update you tomorrow on how that deal went. I went ahead and sent them the post information and everything. And yeah, tomorrow we'll check if the product is actually a winner or not. And yeah, guys, I hope you did enjoy this video. Again, guys, if you do want to win that store after the 7 days, once it's hit the 1K in sales, I'll be giving it away. So you want to be super engaged in the comment section down below. If you want to have the chance to win that store, comment 1K gang down below and you are more likely to win the store just because I know you're a part of the true Phil fam. So with that being said, guys, make sure to subscribe to my channel. You don't want to miss any awesome content like this. Day 5, 6, and 7 are coming, and you want to see how exactly I scale to 1K in sales, then you want to be making sure that you're watching those videos. And also, notification bell icon, so you're notified every time I drop another video inside of the series. And also, like this video, because remember, if you're super engaged, then you're more likely to win. So make sure you're liking this video. We haven't had a single dislike on this challenge series so far. So I respect that, guys. So thank you for that. And yeah, guys, I hope you did enjoy this video. And peace. Whoa, I forgot to mention. Nearly forgot to mention. You have to follow me on Instagram at alexphilip_1. I reply to any of your questions within like 1 to 2 days. If you do have any, so if you have anything specific, not general questions, because I sometimes get general questions like, can you help me make money or teach me how to make money? Like, I don't reply to those ones because it's not specific. If you ask me something specific, I'll get back to you fast. If it's something general like that, I probably won't even get back to you. So you can ask me any questions there, but make sure you follow me before you do so. And yeah, guys, we're trying to hit 8,000 subs by the end of the year. I'm sure we can. So make sure you're part of that 8,000 gang. And yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed. Peace.